As the old saying goes, all things must come to an end, and even on the staggering timeline of the cosmos, that old saying is still applicable to the many celestial bodies that make up the fabric of our universe. White dwarfs, red dwarfs, entire solar systems worth of planets, hell, even black holes have an expiration date, all of which spell bad news for humanity, given the fact that all of these cosmic entities are far, far more destructive than we could ever imagine. But we are a resourceful and resilient species for the most part, so are we going to shuffle off this mortal coil in a brief, insignificant, passing evolutionary moment, or are we going to do something about it? Yeah, that's the spirit. Let's find out. Hello, Internet, what's going on? And once again, welcome back to the most inquisitive channel on YouTube, Life's Biggest Questions. As per usual, I'll be your disembodied floating voice, Jack Finch, as today we curiously ask the question, what if humanity outlived the Earth and the Sun? Roll the clip.
Welcome to the observatory. What can I show you?
For the curious amongst you, that scene was from 2016's Passengers, starring Chris Pratt and Jennifer Lawrence as two humans hurtling through space in a massive cosmic arc, freshly woken up from their cryogenic slumber, which, whilst not being the greatest movie ever made, also serves to paint a very vivid picture and directly address the fact that if humanity was to ever outlive our own sun and subsequent solar system, then we'd certainly need to make some progress through our civilization's tech tree quite considerably beforehand. It leads us neatly to the first point that we'll have to make when we are asking this question, and while it may seem like some kind of giant leap for mankind, it's actually quite simple when addressing this hypothetical notion. If we want to stand any chance of outliving our own solar system, then we'd have to have left Earth way, way before any of those celestial bodies showed any signs of exploding in a blaze of cosmic hellfire. And the truth of the matter is, with the way things are currently looking over here on planet Earth, we may have just enough reason to do so. Nuclear war and mutually assured destruction, cataclysmic climate change, an apocalyptic geostorms, a global pandemic, hell, even throw a horde of rage-ridden zombies in there too, and we've got the stark reality of our planet facing all manners of existential crises, even if a few of them are fictional. The fact of the matter is, if we take the great filter theory into account, all of these situations are sadly unavoidable. There's nothing that we can really do to prevent these cataclysms when they come, but it's in our response to this impending crisis where our true destiny will be forged. And actually, if we overcome the doom that threatens our civilization hanging in the balance on a knife's edge, a bright, bright future awaits us. And in the immortal words of Captain Jean-Luc Picard, engage. The nearest estimation to the age of our planet is 4.543 billion years. As a benchmark, humans have been on this planet for a fraction of a second, around 200,000 years, in comparison to Earth's incomprehensible age. On the flip side to that, our life-giving star, the Sun, is approximately 4.603 billion years old. And the most likely cause of our planet's destruction is going to depend on how and when the final few years of our sun's life plays out. I mean, that's not to somehow imagine that Earth would survive without the sun, because either way, our planet is toast, but it could offer some critical choices for our future human civilization if we made it through the parameters of the Great Filter. Scientists have found that the most likely cause of our sun's solar demise is as a planetary nebula, which, to cut a long story short, is a luminous bubble of gas and dust that eats everything. Nearest estimations figure that our sun will reach the end of its life in about 10 billion years, but in about 5 billion years, it will already be due to turn into a red giant. Essentially, the sun will run out of hydrogen to burn as its fuel and instead switch to helium, where it will be due to turn into a red giant. Essentially, the core of our star will shrink, but its outer layers will expand out to around the orbit of Mars, where planet Earth will then be engulfed in the process. That's if it already hasn't been destroyed through all manners of Armageddon-y possibilities. But whilst it sounds like we have about 5 billion years before the whole thing goes kaput, which sounds like a hell of a long time for our species to have gotten their shtick together and hurtled up the Kardashev scale, proudly considering ourselves as a Type 2 civilization at the least, the reality is that it's much, much shorter than that. One fifth, in fact. As things stand, humanity has about a billion years to figure out how to get off this blue, beautiful rock, perhaps preserving it in the process, down to the fact that the sun is set to increase in brightness around every billion years, and even the slightest increase in luminosity will evaporate all life on Earth, even evaporating our oceans in the process. Again, pointing toward the fact that for our civilization to outlive this impending doom, we better get a much better handle on this whole exploring the cosmos deal. And the thing is, on paper at least, we could do just that. You see, the real kicker is, as we all had learned in preschool, sharing is caring. And this whole spacefaring civilization thing depends on humanity finding the combined will to put into place what is necessary to do so. Especially in the past decade, there have been many proposed methods for colonizing the rest of our solar system, and even several other proposals to begin shifting toward the colonization of other star systems. Now, it's granted that all of these things require production increase in technology, as well as its most important component, energy. As you may imagine, it's no use dreaming up plans to colonize Mars, and then perhaps even the solar system of our nearest neighboring star, Proxima Centauri, without any kind of means to get there in the first place. After all, we can't put the cart before the horse. Or is it the horse before the cart, in this case? Either way, spaceships. Whilst Mars is definitely already on the table in terms of beginning colonization in our lifetime, even with the comparatively inefficient method of space transport that we currently have in operation, this hypothetical question needs to turn our eyes toward the bigger prize. Because to outlive our Earth and our Sun, we'd have to first develop sufficient technology that gets us to an equally friendly planet and star in the meantime. Helium-3 powered fusion rocket propulsion, the thermonuclear busted ramjet, solar sails, antimatter engines, warp drives, whichever way we get there is going to cost a pretty penny, and it's also going to require cooperation on a planetary scale to ever become a reachable future. Most scientists consider that the most feasible way for us to become an intergalactic species is on massive ark-like ships, housing entire generations of humans that live and die on their way to their new home. Many others, however, consider this to be a short-sighted endeavor and point out that theoretically, we could make it to Proxima Centauri on a solar sail-powered vessel in just under 10 years. Although it would take around 17,000 terawatts of power, pretty much what the entire world consumes in a single day. You see, theoretically speaking, it is entirely possible for our species to outlive the death of our own star, as well as the tragic demise of our own home planet in the process. It's just going to take some teamwork and a bit of elbow grease. But who knows, perhaps one day, a billion years from now, out in the Andromeda Galaxy, in some shady bar ran by a gang of sentient reptiles, a lonely human will be having a drink whilst watching the live news feed of our sun as it transitions into a red giant. And then a single tear will roll down their cheek as they say goodbye to a home planet that they never even knew. Well, there we have it, our long and short answer to the question, what if humans outlived the Earth and the Sun? What did you guys think? Do you agree or do you disagree? Then please let us know your thoughts down in the comment section below, as well as any interesting insights of your own. Before we depart from today's video though, if you'd like to continue on with your questioning binge, please feel free to hit our most relevant playlist neatly compiled for your latest impending existential crisis. However, please do not exceed your recommended daily dosage. On that note, unfortunately, that's all we've got time for in today's video. Just stick around all the way until the end. If you were a fan of this video or just life's biggest questions in general, then please be a dear and hit that thumbs up button, as well as that subscribe bell, and I'll be seeing you in the next one. As per usual, I've been your disembodied floating voice, Jack Finch. You've been watching Life's Biggest Questions, and until next time, you take it easy.